understands that government was working a long time ago. The whole thing is for sale. And basically, it's guys that go after power so they can sell influence, selling influence to the guys, the sharks that are running the finance setup in Wall Street, and the sharks and the corporations. And basically, that's been the game for a long time. I know because 30 years ago, I was in the Congress offices when they were on the make. My fix for it is that we got to throw out the whole political system, and we have to get 1,200 guys down there who have been successes in life and know how to think and solve problems and who have made the United States of America work. I've got 107-month spacecraft controls. That's my cellmate. Do you see the system any other way? As far as I'm concerned, you can't do anything but throw everybody out and start fresh and only let people in government. We only need 1,200 out of 300 million. Guys have been a real success. Politics doesn't work. It has the wrong type of individual in it. Now, you may be an exception. I don't know you well enough. But I'd like to know what your view of the complete mess that we've got down there is. None of the guys that caused this whole thing in Wall Street or none of them went to jail. It's complete incompetence and complete dishonesty.
Influence in our government. I led the fight against the $700 billion bank bailout. And people will say we lost because the second time they brought up the bill, it passed. But the original plan of TARP was toxic asset recovery program. And what's a toxic asset? It's the worst bonds in the backs of the safes of the biggest banks. And that plan was cash for trash, that the federal government would relieve the banks of the burden of having invested in really bad bonds by buying those bonds for taxpayer money. By the time we fought that bill, and shine the light on it, they didn't dare do what they were planning to do. And so they didn't do the toxic asset recovery program. They took that same bill and did something less than half as bad, and that is bailed out the banks by buying preferred stock. Most of that money we're getting back because, well, just ask, you don't need an MBA. Ask any 11-year-old, what's a better investment? You want to buy toxic assets? Or do you want to buy preferred stock? Now, as to whether Congress would do better with 1,200 people who have been successes in other lines of work, I was pretty successful before I went to Congress, so if we can disqualify my opponents on that basis, I might be intrigued. But the fact is that it's up to the people to decide who to elect, and if somebody has been even unsuccessful in business, or someone's been a homemaker, or someone has had a factory job, and doesn't claim it may have been unsuccessful in manufacturing. I think it's up to the voters to decide whether being successful in the private sector is the be-all and end-all. I mean, obviously, Mitt Romney makes more money in the private sector in an hour than Barack Obama made in a year when he was in the private sector, or at least the non-governmental sector. So I'd like to see a Congress made up of good people. We all would. We want to see a Congress that does the right thing for America. We all would. But I think we're going to have to elect them. And if you strongly believe that success in the private sector ought to be the most important criteria, I'd agree with you as long as my opponent had less demonstrated success in the private sector than I did.